Hello, Cinternet. Can you tell what we are doing?
Happy Mardi Gras, or whatever they say.
Yeah, I don't know. We've never been there.
Party!
But it looks like we have. This is all brought to you by when we lived in Vegas.
We're going to be making Captain Morgan hurricanes tonight. So she's going to talk while I start making.
Okay. First, you got to get you some kind of fancy glass. We just so happen to have a Gallenberg glass from where we were down there a few years ago. And his glass is a traditional hurricane glass from Louisville, Kentucky.
A Hard Rock in Louisville.
That was from Bubba Gump
and Gatlinburg.
Yeah. And then our shot glass that we will be using tonight is a double-sided shot glass. I don't know. I haven't read the directions on this. It's all him on the direction part. But this is from Dick/Resort in Gatlinburg.
We also went to the one in Vegas. Well, a lot of this stuff is from Vegas.
I said that.
Oh, did
this
you?
This is all. A lot of this is brought to you by Vegas because we've never been to Mardi Gras.
Right. A little bit of it was brought to you by a place that's no longer in existence. But
yes, in Indiana, it went out of business.
Actually, it started Louisville, Lexington, and Indiana.
I don't know much about these things, but all right. What we need first.
First thing you need is alcohol.
Yes.
And what you get is you get some Captain Morgan original spiced rum, some Captain Morgan white rum. It says put 0.75 ounces in it, but you know, I'm going to put about an ounce each. 0.75 each, I'm going to do an ounce each. You're going to be putting this in the shakers.
Oh, you're shaking me some too?
We're going at the same time, girl.
And we're going to make it fancy with umbrellas, which we got whenever we went to the beach a few years ago, and we got these. I will stab you some cherries.
Surprise me, and there's the cherry.
We're going to put a little cherry on the sun. These umbrellas are really easy. They have a band that goes on the thing. You push the band down, and then there's another little band. I don't know if you can see it. Right here, there's a little band. You fluff your umbrella.
Yeah.
Push that little band up, and boom, it's an umbrella.
Then it says about 2 ounces.
Let's see if I got
passion fruit juice.
Oh, they were already open. These are big, fat cherries, which we're going to stick in an umbrella. I'm just going to stick that right there. How many cherries you want on your stick? Oh. Sounds horrible. How many cherries you want on your stick?
The next. All right, that was the passion fruit. And then next, I think we're going to throw some orange juice in there. And it's going to be an ounce.
Passion fruit.
Of orange juice.
How many cherries you want on your stick? I'm going to put 2.
Yeah, I'll take 2. All right. Gotta do the juice of a half a lime.
But you do not have to have the cherries and the umbrella. We just figured we'd make it look a little more fancy and cute.
I don't know, what would you say a half a lime is?
I have no idea.
That looks good to me.
I'm just over here making a cherry mess.
Don't want to taste nothing but lime. So.
Right.
That ought to be good. What do you think?
Couple squeezes from the juice.
Tablespoon.
This is what kind of lime juice we're using.
And a tablespoon of simple syrup and a tablespoon of grenadine.
This may have worked better and been quicker if it was all measured out and ready to go before we started this video, but we're trying to make it so you can see how it's made.
Usually I make drinks as I go because I don't have like a million things to, you know,
to mix this stuff in. And this is
the cap to that. It's not on.
simple syrup. What are we going to do with this lemon? I mean, this orange. With this orange, because it's such a lemon.
Slice it. You know how to slice it? Just make slices. I believe this is where we shake.
That should be good, right?
I think so. Oh, yeah.
So, what are we doing with
and
this
one? And then just put a slice towards the center so you can slide it down on the edge of your glass.
Making it pretty. Oh, my goodness. I found a big old fatty piece for the other one. Party foul. Aw. At least it fell onto the plate. It was like, I'm not partying today, y'all.
Well, it ain't gonna fill it up.
I'm not very good at cutting these lemon or oranges. I'm still stuck on a lemon.
Yeah, I think we're gonna stick with the
high-tech,
the professional one there.
This one we've had forever. I don't know if you could see it. But the, oh my gosh, that's horrible sounding. The base of it has measurements for different kinds of drinks. Maybe one day we'll get venturous and make some drinks off of our martini shaker thingy. But here is what the finished product looks like. Is this a fail or a good job? Can't really see the cherries.
I can't drink mine with all the stuff on it. Well, I can tell you what, the taste of the finished product is a fucking, oh, it's delicious.
Oh, that's good. Disappear fruit, you're in the way.
I can drink these all night.
Heck yeah. These are awesome.
Oh, yeah, they are.
Throw me a cherry in there.
Yeah, I'm going to throw me some cherries in here, too. I wonder if them alcohol... The moonshine cherries would be good in this.
They may be. Cheers, dear.
Cheers. I'm sorry. I want to drink without cheersing.
I did, too.
Happy Mardi Gras, guys. Drink you some hurricanes.
This might not make it to
this
Mardi Gras.
This was the...
But you could still party at home like you're
there.
This
was the Captain Morgan hurricane recipe. We got it from Captain Morgan.
Come back tomorrow to see what we will be doing for Mardi Gras on Fat Tuesday.
This is good. This is really good. That's like one of the best hurricanes I think I've ever had.
I know. I've had them from bars and they ain't been this good. I like it. But like I said, come back tomorrow and see what we'll be doing for Fat Tuesday. Maybe we should marinate the fruit in that for the night. Make a big thing of it for tomorrow or something.
You just get out a pitcher.
Big party.
And like quadruple the, like octuple the freaking ingredients and just make a big pitcher of it.
Yeah. These are really good. I suggest going out and buying the stuff it takes to make it. And
it's super
making
delicious.
It at home because it is really good. Like I said, I've had them at bars, and they have not been this good. This one, Captain Morgan's got it right. Not sponsored.
Let's see, should we say the price of some things? I know this was $12. This was like $15. This was $2. The orange juice was $3.
This was probably $2.
Yeah, that was around $2. This was, I can't remember the lime and the simple syrup because we already had it. But, I mean, it's not, like, super expensive.
Yeah,
this
not,
was around, like, what, $2 or $3?
Yeah, it's not really expensive to make this at home. It's probably cheaper to make it at home than to go to a bar to get one for the fact that you can make lots of them.
Oh, yeah, what we just had would have been, like, $7, $8
yeah,
at a bar.
Yeah, this would be, like, $7 or $8. I mean, they would have probably filled the glass a little more, but for what you're getting, is it really worth $7 or $8?
I mean, if all you're going to drink is one, then...
Yeah, and chances are when they're making it at the bar that you're at, when they add the ice, they really add the ice, so you only get, like, what, a couple drinks out of it? But because I can see this video is already really long, don't forget to come back tomorrow on Fat Tuesday to see what we are going to be up to, because we are going to do another Mardi Gras type video. I know that Mondays and Tuesdays are not really days that I post videos about food and drinks, but this week, because it's a special week, I am going to be posting those videos on those days. And starting next week, it will be back to normal because I don't think there's anything going on. Fish fry starts. You have a church nearby, hit them up and go check out that fish fry. You don't have to be part of the church to do it. Just go hit it up for a cheap meal. And if all the fish fries are like where we go, you get a lot of food for a little price.
Good, too.
Yeah. I'm gonna wrap this up so we can make more of these and start preparing for tomorrow's crazy video. As I always say, show me some love, like, comment, subscribe, check that box below and see all the other places I am on the internet, and I will catch you later.
Show me boobies.